last lecture, we saw the origin of energy gap. And in this lecture, we will see the origin of energy bands formation in solid. So for this, I am taking a very simple example of sodium. We know that atomic number of sodium is 11 and its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 and 3s1. I am sure all of you know about it. It means first two electrons will go to 1s energy state and next two electrons will go to 2s energy state. And next six electrons will go to 2p energy states and next one electron will go to 3s energy state. We can also, and we know that an individual atom can only take discrete energy states, so we can make a graph of these energy states like this. So this line belongs to 1s state, this line belongs to 2s energy state and so on. These are two individual sodium atoms and here we can see that every single state has two electrons and we know that according to Pauli exclusion principle only two electrons with opposite spin can take a single energy state. Here due to there are three orbitals in 2p, that is px, py and pz, and each orbital can take two electrons, so there are six electrons in 2p energy state. Similarly, one electron is in 3s state. Now these two atoms are individual and they are very far apart from each other. So now we have to see what will happen when we bring these two atoms close to each other. So first we have to concentrate on these field energy states, and this empty energy state is very helpful in understanding of the overlapping of energy bands in metal. So first let us consider this 1s state. So I am drawing this 1s state for this atom and this 1s state for this atom. Now they are very far, so we can say there are two electrons in this state and two electrons in this state. But when we bring these two states close to each other, let's say like this, now this is a single state, and if we draw electrons as earlier, now there should be four electrons. But according to Pauli exclusion principle, we know that for a single energy state we can put only two electrons and those two electrons must be with opposite spin, so we can't make a single state using two individual states. So but this problem can be solved if we split this energy state into two different energy states. That is, one is above this state and one is below this state. Here I am erasing this, and one is below this state. So now we can accommodate four electrons in these two states. That is, two electron will go here and two electron with opposite spins go here. So now we can see that a single state is splitted into two individual states, and this is sodium atom and this is Na2, we can say molecule of a sodium. So in this way we can see that if we take two atoms and we bring close to these atoms, every individual state will split into two energy states. And in another image we can see similarly here, because there are two atoms of sodium, so a single state will split into two energy states. And when we take three individual atoms and when we bring close to these atoms, a single energy state will split into three states. And here we can see that the gap between these two states is larger than the gap between these two states. As we increase the number of atoms, the energy gap between these states will decrease. So according to Pauli exclusion principle, as I said earlier, we can fill the electrons in these states. There are two electrons for this lower energy state, two electrons for higher energy state, and so on. And since there are three orbitals in p cell, so we can fill here six electron, two in px, two in py, and two in pz orbitals. So there are 12 electrons total. Similarly, for three atoms, there are three states, or a single state will split into three energy states, and here we can accommodate electrons by using Pauli exclusion principle. And when we bring n atoms together, here we can see that the first energy state will split into 2n states, 2s state also split into 2n, and p states will split into 6n states. So because now we are increasing the number of atoms, so gap between these states is going to decrease. So instead of these individual state, here we can see a bands of energy states, and these bands are known as energy bands. So here one energy band is for 1s state, another energy band is for 2s state, and so on. And this is the energy gap or band gap between these field and empty state. Here I am using a simple concept, and I am showing only filled and filled, unfilled energy states. So here we can see that as we bring n number of atoms together, we can see energy bands formation in solids. And in a simple way, here we can see that here I am using a lithium example, that when two atoms or n atoms are at infinite distance, then all individual atoms acts like a single atoms and all of their energy states are discrete. And when we bring close to these atoms, these states at equilibrium position will split into energy bands. So in lithium we can see these bands are fully filled and completely filled, and these bands are empty. This is vacuum level. So in this way we can see the formation of energy bands in solids. Now I am going to take an example by which we can see the band gap and overlapping of bands in solids. For this, first I am taking an example of silicon, and we know that atomic number of silicon is 14 and its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2 and 3p1. Sorry, 3p2. So, and as I discussed in earlier lecture, when we bring two atoms of silicon close to each other, these energy states following hybridization will split into four orbitals of equal energy. So if, let me draw it here. I'm only using this valence bands. So for 3s, if this is 3s and this is 3p orbitals. So in this configuration, two electrons are in 3s orbital and two electrons are here. But when we bring two or more atoms together, and since there is no much energy difference between these orbitals, these atomic orbitals due to hybridization will make four molecular orbitals of equal energy. This can also be seen in this example, that is in silicon, these individual states due to hybridization will appear in four molecular orbitals, and again there are, due to bonding and antibonding, there are energy bands. And if we see this in a very simple language, we can see that for a individual silicon atom, due to hybridization, since there are 8 states or there are 4 states, and सॉरी देयर आर फोर स्टेट्स एंड देयर कुड बी मैक्सिमम एट इलेक्ट्रॉन इन दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन दिस स्टेट्स. सो ड्यू टू हाइब्रिडाइजेशन फॉर ए सिंगल सिलिकन देयर आर फोर मोलिकुलर ऑर्बिटल्स. So this is for the individual silicon atom, and when we bring another silicon atom with same configuration, now we have to understand this concept. Now we know that each individual state can take two electrons. So when we make a bond of these silicon atoms, we can make these orbitals like this. Since each individual orbital or state can take two electrons, so all these eight electrons are filled into these orbitals. Now we can see that these orbitals are fully filled, and these orbitals are empty. So now, since these orbitals are completely filled, there is a stability in for these orbitals, and these orbitals are very unstable. So there is a band gap between these empty and filled orbitals. So in this way we can see that there is a band gap or energy gap between filled and empty bands of for silicon. And so therefore silicon behaves as insulator at absolute zero temperature. This is I am talking at absolute zero temperature, but as we increase the temperature, some electrons will jump from this to this, and silicon can conduct electricity. So we know that these empty orbitals or bands are known as conduction band, and these filled bands are known as valence band. So since there is a energy gap between filled and conduction band and valence band, so and this gap is smaller, therefore we call silicon a semiconductor. But important thing here is, what will be happened when there is three electrons only? That is, if we take example of aluminium, atomic number of aluminium is 13, and we know that for aluminium, for a individual aluminium atom, there are three electrons only. One S two, three S two, and three P one. If we consider this, now when we bring two aluminium atoms together, So when we bring two aluminum atoms together, there are again four orbitals for another aluminum atom. These two are, here is one. And if we make these orbitals like this, 1, 4, 3s, and 2p3. Similarly, this one, 2 atoms make a bond which is known as a metallic bond, and similar to silicon we can make here like this. This is 3s, this is 3p, after bonding, if lower energy states can accommodate 2 electrons, then all electrons will be filled only into 3 orbitals, and 1 lower energy orbital is empty. So here we can see, since these lower energy states are not stable, and at the same time there are empty energy states, so there is a overlapping of valence band and conduction bands in aluminium. This is valence bands that has 6 electrons. And other states are empty. So in this way, there is an overlapping of bands into this aluminium. And now another question is, what will be happened when we add 1 electron in silicon configuration? That is, if we make electronic configuration of atomic number 15, and this is very important, because in that case, since these states are filled, so there is stability, there must be some band gap, and 1 electron will go here. So in that case, scenario will be very different, and I am leaving it up to you that you can check what will be in that scenario. So I am explaining here the overlapping and overlapping of bands and band gap in insulator or semiconductor by using this bonding methods. It's very simple to understand, and I'm sure you can understand this concept. In next lecture, we will study the types of band gaps